Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, you'll learn how to dynamically discount prices based on product title or other attributes. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. In this case, let's say in our site we have products for men, women and baby. We offer 20% discounts on products having the title men and 10% discount on products having the title women, and other products will be the same. So what do you do? The solution is using dynamic attributes. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So let's go ahead and create a new attribute to give a discount for men. Let's go click on the add new button. Let's give it a name. Discount for men. Boom, done. Let's go ahead and add a condition. For condition, what we're going to add is if price greater than 0 is going to give us a value, and the value is going to be a 20% discount. There we go, that's done. For attribute, let's keep the default as price. There we go. Let's go ahead and save this. Now let's go ahead and create the dynamic attribute for the women's discount. Click on add new again. Let's give it a name. Discount for women. There we go. And let's go ahead and add the condition. In this case, once again, we're going to choose the price. Let's choose that. If it's greater than 0, then return the value pattern and it's minus 10%. So that's the discount we're offering right now. And this for default, we're going to keep it at price. Boom, there we go. Now that we have created our discounts, finally we need to create a dynamic attribute to modify the prices in the feed. This is how you can do that. Click on add new to create a new dynamic attribute. Let's give it a name, discount for men and women. Done. Let's go ahead and add the conditions for this dynamic attribute. I'll add the condition. Let's say when the product title contains the word men, it will return us the attribute, the new dynamic attribute which we've created, which is going to be a discount for men. Let's see if I can find that. There we go, discount for men. Let's add another one. Once again, when the product title contains the word, there we go, contains the word woman, then the attribute it will return us is the discount for women. Let's see if I can find that. There we go, discount for women. And for the default attribute, we want price to be returned. There we go, perfect. Let's go ahead and save this. Now that our dynamic attributes are ready, we need to add this output value to our feed. So let's go to our feed. Let's go to custom. As you can see here in our feed, we have price and we've got sale price. I'll change this attribute to the new dynamic attribute that you have just created so that it picks up the correct discounts. Let's see if you can find it. There we go. Discounts for men and women. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. Now that our feed is ready, let's go ahead and take a look. There you go, guys. As you can see, since this product title contains the word men, this is getting a 20% discount. Similarly, this one contains the word woman, so instead it's getting a 10% discount. Other products which contains words like baby and all the other stuff, there are no discounts. As you can see, this is $45 and this is $45 and nothing else has changed. There you go, guys. Now you know how you can dynamically discount prices on product title or other attributes. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.